First, a scientist begins with the perception of a problem.
Science is hard. Scientists spend a lot of time making guesses and having them be wrong.
One of the big mysteries of life itself is the cell and how cells work, and many of the most prevalent diseases can be traced back to disorders of the cell.
There is an ambitious, globe-spanning effort underway to create cell atlases, detailed maps of all the cells in a human body.
The problem is, in each of our bodies, there's 37 trillion cells, and at this point now, experiments can be run with millions of cells.
How do you analyze and page through all this data?
That challenge is a really big one.
The information needed to create a complete cell atlas is rich, difficult to interpret, and not easily searchable by all the biologists that would benefit from it.
And so we developed a tool called CellxGENE.
The hope with a tool like CellxGENE is that the time that it takes to come up with and address hypotheses becomes very short.
The more we have a better fundamental understanding of how these cells work, the better we're going to be able to understand these diseases and perhaps one day cure them. The history of science teaches us that discovery is often driven by the development of new tools. It's tools that enable you to ask questions you haven't asked before. My name's Steve Quake. I'm the head of science at CZI. Cell biology is at an amazing inflection point where new technologies are revolutionizing the kind of information one can collect about cells and their behavior and their identities. And we made a very large and significant investment in developing cell atlases.
These atlases plot out what cells exist and where, essentially unveiling the smallest building blocks of the human body.
If you want to understand distinct features that make the Rockies really unique as compared to the plains, the same questions can be asked of cells that are in the liver versus the pancreas. And so for those looking at developing drugs or precision medicine, having the knowledge of where diseases are acting or where genes are acting is going to be incredibly powerful.
When we started making these cell atlases, it involved a small group of experts. But as we got into it and the team grew, we added people who had different kinds of expertise.
Quake's team realized that if they could improve access and collaboration between researchers, efforts around the world to create cell atlases could move faster and more effectively. And so, Chan Zuckerberg CellxGENE was born.
What CellxGENE does is it makes data exploration and analysis at scale much easier. It's really a resource that's intended to serve the community.
CellxGENE is designed to be easily navigable and freely accessible for labs and individuals around the world. And so far, it's made more than 30 million cells worth of data available for researchers in need of single-cell data and for teams working on building cell atlases.
We need to have an understanding of what does it mean to be healthy? What does the reference look like?
Angela Pisco is a data scientist at the Chan Zuckerberg BioHub and works on Tabula Sapiens, a cell atlas that launched with nearly 500,000 cells from 24 organs collected from the same 15 individuals and continues to grow.
The goal of the project is to get a comprehensive characterization of as many tissues and organs as we can from single donors.
Being able to look at cells captured from multiple organs from single individuals, remove some of the variability and biological bias that you might see in other studies. And so CellxGENE has helped the team go through and annotate those data sets increasingly quickly.
So we have the Tabula Sapiens samples. We are basically cutting it to put the barcodes in that will then let us identify which fragments of the DNA are coming from each cell.
In 2022, alongside three other milestone papers, Tabula Sapiens published their benchmark first draft, and it's already uncovered new revelations about cells across the human body.
When you use CellxGENE to explore the Tabula Sapiens, you open it up, and it shows you a plethora of different cell types, all in different clouds, different colors. You can circle any of them and do a deep dive into what genes they're expressing that makes one different than the other.
Here we can select regions so that we can start to learn something about what makes one region unique and distinct from some of the middle ones.
Working together collaboratively across institutions enables us to make sort of the best possible data set for people to use and avoid it being a Tower of Babel where everyone's done everything a little differently and it's not entirely compatible. Tabula Sapiens and the other cell atlases we're working on will have impact globally on science because people everywhere who are trying to understand mysteries of the cell or their particular tissue now have a complete molecular portrait of those cell types, leading us to new therapeutics and better understanding of human disease.
By making our data available, we really hope to inspire the rest of the scientific community to partner with us and really to take a very collaborative approach at paving the way to build the Human Cell Atlas.
What excites me about the future of single-cell biology and the utility of CELLxGENE is that I think we're at the beginning. And eventually, I do believe that it will be a foundational reference that will be useful for every biomedical scientist in the world. So in the same way that we now think of resources like the periodic table or like the human genome, I think that's where we're going with single-cell biology and a human cell atlas.